Let me ask you something. Have you ever wanted to hack like in the movies, you know, screens flashing, firewalls falling, typing furiously while sipping Red Bull in a dark basement? Yeah, real hacking isn't exactly like that. No exploding servers, no access granted screen after typing three lines of code, but becoming a hacker in 2025, that's real and insanely cool. In this video, I'm going to show you step by step how to actually become a hacker, what tools to use, what skills to learn, and yes, even how to hack Wi-Fi on your own network, obviously. But hey, this isn't a boring theory lecture. You'll get real practical knowledge, stuff you can actually use. Step one, the setup, what you need before you even start hacking. So first of all, no, you can't hack using your grandpa's Nokia 3310, and no, your school Chromebook won't cut it either. You need a proper machine. Ideally, a laptop or desktop with at least 8 gigabytes of RAM. Better if you can run VirtualBox or VMware for virtual machines. And most importantly, a Wi-Fi adapter that supports packet injection. Yep, your regular Wi-Fi card won't let you crack Wi-Fi networks. So grab something like the Alpha AWS 036 ACH. It's a beast. Also, install Kali Linux, either as a virtual machine, dual boot, or live USB, because Kali is like Batman's utility belt. Every tool you need to break into and secure systems is right in there. Step two, learn the basics first. Don't be that tool kiddie. Before you start shouting hack the planet and launching tools, slow down. You need the basics. Learn how networks work. IP, MAC, DNS, DHCP, you gotta know these. Understand Linux commands, because 90% of hacking happens in the terminal. Get good at Google hacking, called Google dorking. And yes, it's a real thing. Learn about ports, protocols, and how websites are built. Because here's the deal, tools are just shortcuts. But if you don't understand what the tool is doing, you're just pushing buttons without knowing why. And trust me, the moment something breaks, you'll be staring at errors like a chicken solving algebra. Step three, start with Wi-Fi hacking, because everyone wants that sweet free internet. All right, let's get spicy. Want to hack Wi-Fi? Here's how it really works on your own router. Relax, you'll need Kali Linux, a packet injection capable Wi-Fi adapter, tools, Airman NG, Aerodump NG, Airplay NG, Aircrack NG, process, use Airmon NG to start monitoring mode, run Aerodump NG to list all nearby networks, lock onto your target and start capturing the handshake, use Airplay NG to deauthenticate someone, force them to reconnect, capture that handshake, feed it into Aircrack NG with a word list to crack the password. Sounds easy? It's not. But when it works, it's glorious, like opening the gates to the internet kingdom. And here's the funny part. This isn't hacking as in the movies. You're just listening to wireless traffic and being smart about how you crack it. Step four, website hacking, using tools like Nikto, SQLMap, and Burp Suite. Next, let's talk websites. They're everywhere, and honestly, most of them are built like IKEA furniture. It looks nice, but one screw loose and it just collapses. So to test websites, you'll want to use Nikto to scan for common vulnerabilities. Then use SQLMap to test for SQL injection. This one's automated, powerful, and, well, kind of deadly if you're not careful. And Burp Suite, it's like Wireshark plus Interceptor plus, I don't know, some hacker magic. You can intercept form data, modify cookies, change GET or POST requests, basically trick the site into saying way too much. Ever heard of someone buying an iPhone for $1? Yeah, that's probably Burp Suite gone wild. Don't do that, please. Step five, social engineering. The human hacking side, you can have firewalls, encryption, AI security, but there's always one weak link, humans. Use the Social Engineer Toolkit, or SET, in Kali to clone a login page, send phishing emails, and trick someone into giving you credentials. Of course, this is all for simulation and awareness testing, because, well, Karen from accounting still clicks you've won a Tesla every single time. Step six, DDoS testing. Don't get yourself arrested. Disclaimer, DDoS is illegal unless you're testing your own server. That being said, tools like HPing 3, Loic, and SlowLoris let you simulate traffic floods. And yeah, it's kind of terrifying watching a site go offline in seconds from a command line, but only do this with permission. Otherwise, you'll be explaining to the police why you took down your cousin's Minecraft server. Step 7. Keep learning, keep breaking stuff. Legally. Want to get even better? Try Hack the Box, Try Hack Me, or CTFs. Break stuff in virtual labs like Metasploitable or DVWA. Follow hacker YouTubers like me for tutorials. And yes, you will fail a lot. You'll rage at tools not working. You'll scream when Wi-Fi doesn't crack. You'll threaten to uninstall Kali Linux, then reinstall it 5 minutes later because honestly, you can't live without it. But hey, that's the hacker's path. If you made it this far, you're either serious about becoming a hacker or you just really like the sound of my voice. Either way, hit that like button, smash subscribe so you don't miss more practical hacking tutorials. Drop a comment. Which part are you most excited to try? Wi-Fi, web hacking, or just looking cool in the terminal? Stay curious, stay ethical, stay sharp.